Hi there. Welcome to 50 Questions Friday for February 17th, 2023. Well, thank you all for your patience here as we have switched back to Livestorm again. Our last platform last week did not work out, and neither has our Soul Alchemy class. But tomorrow we're having, for those of you who are here that are part of Soul Alchemy, we will have our second class tomorrow morning, and then the next one Wednesday, taking a week off, and then we will be every week until March 23rd. So the Soul Alchemy class, it's basically going to be, I do sessions of bringing in the Master Creator You, which is simply taking all of your soul aspects, the ego, lifetimes, experiences, traumas, all of that, bringing it in as wisdom. And basically we step ourselves into you as that Master Creator after we amass all that wisdom, bringing all that experience in. And basically that forms the Master You. It's kind of an intermediary between you and your soul. It's something that has had lifetime experiences, is something that you can more relate with more than the soul. But basically this five-week class is geared towards getting us to that space that we do in our sessions. And I just can't do a meditation with this because there's a lot of things that can occur. So we were covering all of our bases with Soul Alchemy. But anyway, good morning. Hello from Oz and Maine. So if you are here for the first time and you're here live, please do drop your questions over here on the questions tab in the chat side. We have a great group of people who are always here who can also help to supplement with questions. So let's see. And what else? If you are watching on YouTube or after the fact, maybe on Facebook, then please do join us live here if you wish. Just sign up for the Twisted Sage newsletters at Twistedsage.com. Clear at the bottom of the homepage and you'll find the newsletter sign up. So anyway, we're going to do a quick three breaths to go into the heart space. And then after that, we'll see where we go. All right, so just closing your eyes, putting your attention to that physical heart where you find your light, your soul's fire within the heart, your spark of divinity. Imagining connecting heart to heart with the earth, with that beautiful spark of light that the earth is, and drawing up, just imagining connecting heart to heart and drawing up that light and supporting energy of the earth right up through the feet, through the body, into the heart. And just feel that deep connection with Mother Earth. She is a very powerful transformer of energies in that when you ground heart to heart with the earth, she will transform energies in your field that you're ready to let go of. So just allow what no longer serves you for the earth. Just take those energies, old emotions, situations, etc. Now from the heart, we connect to the heart of you as Source, Soul, Creator, God. So imagine as you take in this breath that your light expands from your heart and into every cell of the body. Your light is always there. It's just putting your attention and allowing your light to expand throughout your being. So what we were doing is called the Trinity breath, if you've never joined us before. And it's basically a three breath technique where we can do it really fast, simple, and easy, taking that breath from earth into the heart, taking that breath from source soul, creator God, into the heart. The third breath is where you become that conduit. You become the one that is grounded to earth, connected to creation, and you are here right now as this beautiful, powerful creator being. All right, so hey, Linda from SoCal. Hey, Renard, good to see you again. Hey, Celia from Ohio. So, let's see if there's any announcements. I don't think so. Just the soul alchemy stuff that we're doing. Not sure of any cool sales going on right now either. We're just kind of plugging along. Going to actually have some announcements. We do have some of our upcoming events listed on the Twisted Sage events page. One of those you might have seen, going to Raleigh, North Carolina for a body, mind, spirit celebration event. Gonna be leaving here Wednesday for that. So we won't have 50 questions Friday, next Friday. I'll be setting up in North Carolina. So if you're in the Raleigh area and you'd like a weekend job, then please get a hold of me. Let's see. Then we have a few different events in Colorado. And I believe we're going to be doing one in Cincinnati here in April. Just getting ready to sign up to do a lot of shows on the road here. So anyway, hey, Renard, cool. Thank you. The Quantum Heart Coils are 14% off until midnight tonight, Mountain Standard Time. So the Quantum Heart Coil pendants are, we're just celebrating our 1 year anniversary. And the copper coil pendant is our most economical pendant, and it's pretty profound. Please do check out some of the testimonials if you're on the fence about the Quantum Heart Coil pendants. They are a great support in their petite, and yeah, they're pretty potent. So anyway, hey, Samson. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get started with our questions. Now, we had a question from last week, which I answered, but I'm afraid that we weren't broadcasting. So the question, our first question from the internet. So this person has a home headset phones, you know, your landline phones that have cordless headsets, and these cordless headsets are all over in the home. And so the question was about working with the EMFs with this. Now, since you have a golden fire generator in the home, the golden fire generator is going to take care of anything that's floating in the waves, right? Now, so truly the thing with electromagnetics that we have to realize is that electromagnetics are not inherently bad whatsoever. EMFs get a bad rap. Now, everything in our reality is electromagnetic. That's not just physical emotions. Everything is in electromagnetics within this realm. And so we have, you know, that's how you see a sunflower grows in the Fibonacci spiral, because of the toroidal field, the electromagnetic tube torus that is around that plant. It's around the seed. These tube toruses, the toroidal field, you'll see is around every physical object, whether from the cell to a planet to a galaxy. And that torus is created with an electromagnetic field. So everything in our reality is electromagnetic. Now, our heart is that huge electromagnetic generator about 6 feet across. It is a very harmonious field. Now, when we get a little bit off center, off kilter, we can have not quite of a strong and harmonious field. So then those discordant electromagnetics that come from man-made electronics, you know, your electrical systems, everything is more of a discordant electrical field. And so with those electrical fields, they can knock people more off balance. But truly, if you can stand grounded, connected, you can stand in balance with you, in your light, in your power, so to speak, you are truly untouchable. I have all these on my phone, but I do not need a single one. I still sleep with my phone by my head at night, but I know my field is a powerful, harmonious field where a discordant electromagnetic will not knock me off kilter. So I don't even need these tabs on my phone because my field harmonizes this field. So the concept with earbuds, as well as handheld cordless phones attached to a landline, they do produce a field, they produce a frequency, they produce, you know, a signal, electromagnetic field, all that stuff. But it's not that powerful of a field. So please know that there are several ways that you can be grounded, centered, aligned, and in your power, electromagnetic power, to where you're not knocked off kilter by an earbud or a phone, or even a phone or other even more potent wireless. So some of the ways that you can stay aligned, grounded, connected is, of course, with the tools, any of the tools, a ring in your pocket, a Wi-Fi ring, a bracelet, a bangle, a pendant. They all help to keep your field harmonious, aligned, balanced. And then you don't have to worry about earbuds or handheld phones. So instead of getting a cell tab and putting onto a wireless handheld phone, just simply have a ring in your pocket or wear a pendant, or you don't need the physical tools. We teach the MerKaBa. The MerKaBa is an electromagnetic field found around the human body. You probably recognize these cards. We send them with every one of our orders, and we have several YouTube videos on the MerKaBa activation, because the MerKaBa does produce an electromagnetic field around the body, and this field is about 50 feet across. So when you activate your MerKaBa field, you're not getting touched by these electromagnetics. Because it is an electromagnetic field that harmonizes them. So that is truly one of the ways that we can clear our EMF sensitivities. And another concept is that we've had people that have called us and said, well, my Golden Fire generator is not clearing this cell phone tower and I'm still getting zapped and oh my. And when we look in, the tools are working just fine, but the person falls into fear. And we are powerful creators, especially when we're in fear. And so even though this Golden Fire generator was harmonizing these electromagnetic fields in their home, their fear and their attention and tuning into this tower, they allowed it in. Simple as that. They helped to create that imbalance. So basically, when we get a phone call like that, we have to talk to the person, get them into their heart space, and get them out of fear. And so really, that's it too, is also knowing in your mind that you are a very powerful bioelectromagnetic being, and that you don't have to be at the whim of discordant electromagnetics. That is truly, for some, really a choice to have that occur. Because, yeah, we are a bioelectromagnetic being. Anyway, I'll stop with the soapbox. All right, Linda, will the rings extend expiration dates on medications, etc.? Well, so kind of like the whole concept of, you know, you heard people using pyramids for years since the 70s, I think even earlier, people have been doing experiments with pyramids and the energetics of pyramids and putting them over fruit to keep fruit longer, putting it over razor blades to keep a razor blade sharp. Well, it's the same basic concept. It's a little bit of a different field, but it's even more harmonious of a field than a pyramid. And so basically with these harmonious fields, it can hold things from degrading as fast. Yes. But I couldn't really say to take, you know, that's my best question. The best answer to that question is that the tensor fields can create longevity in substances, organic and otherwise. But a tensor ring is phenomenal to put on medications because it clears the energetics that are connected to those medications. Like my father, when he was alive, he could not take pharmaceuticals, not because of the physiological, but because of the energetic component attached to pharmaceuticals. So using tensor ring with your medications is a phenomenal idea. And then when you set your medications inside of that tensor ring, also have an intention that all of that medication is harmonized to you. And then that's it. And then you take your bottle out and you don't have to do it again. Your whole bottle is cleared. What do you suggest for air and water toxicity? So the Harmony generator is a good one. Just because the Harmony has the largest sphere of influence out of all the tensor field generators that we have, and it is working more with the plant and animal and just nature, the nature divas, the land. So it kind of depends too on what level of toxicity you're really working with. You know, the harmony generator is basically going to cover, you know, the 7.5-inch one's about 12 mile sphere of influence. And of course that goes down into waterways and such, but that one's going to be basically holding space for all of nature to, you know, it's holding space for nature. But to really get in and do some of the deep clearing, especially if it's in underground waterways and, you know, aquifers, then the Wings of Talk is really a great one, because the Wings of Talk is one that when you place it on the ground, it is connecting in with the underground waterways, all of that. And it's doing that clearing below the surface of the earth. Now, air and water toxicity, you know, really too, is working with the elementals. So the elemental symbols that we create, the symbols are basically there just for you to help connect with these elementals, the spirits of air, of water, of wind. And so really that is a great way to do it, through consciousness, through not using tools and setting tools out and going out and gritting and everything. I mean, that's what you can use your Harmony generator for, the Wings of Talk. But if you want to work with the air and the water through just your intent in using your superpowers of holding space, of being in the heart and shining light, then yeah, working with the elementals is a good one. So you go into the heart space and you just look at that photo of those elemental symbols that we have of Hedica, of Kaleem and Plymela, which are the air and the wind. And you can start working with them and just asking them to come through and hold space and just say, okay, in my heart, I'm connecting with these elementals. I'm connecting with this space and the environment. And I'm in my heart, so I'm not in fear and I'm not trying to fix and repair. I'm simply in my heart and sharing my light and the light of these elements with the environment. Because you know, that's kind of the newer way of doing things, is simply holding the space and allowing the highest potentials to come through. You know, you, the old way would be a lot of doing and a lot of visualization and, okay, I'm going to have Plymela come in here and blow these winds out, and I'm going to have Colleen come in and clear the air, and Hedica come in and clear the water. But we really limit ourselves when we are specific and we try to direct the energies from the brain. So that's why it's important to be in the heart space and simply just bring everything into your awareness and allow for the highest potentials to come through. So that really is a way that you can work with air and water toxicity, is just being and holding that space for them. And again, you can use the physical tools that I mentioned. Been doing astral projection practice since the last month, and I can't seem to get myself to detach from my body. Can you suggest anything? No, because I don't really, I am not experienced in traditional astral travel. I mean, maybe that's what I do. I mean, I go all over the multiverse, you know, and basically it's just wherever you want to go, you just go. And that's for me. But as far as astral traveling, can't get yourself to detach from the body, I really, really don't know. Because my awareness and perception isn't there, and it's not something I do in this fashion. But I do know that, you know, my sisters talked a bit about astral travel and such, and about how you do have that cord that connects to your body, so you can never, you know, be lost. You know, was it a silver or gold cord or something that connects your body to you as you travel? But there's, my feeling is that there's different yous that travel. So the astral travel is almost like it's the aspect of the human that comes off the body and goes. For me, when I do astral travel, when I go places, it's just simply projecting my consciousness. And so my consciousness is there. It's not like I'm taking this aspect of the physical there. So that's where I, you know, that's what I know how to do, is to project consciousness. Is the MerKaBa enough for protection in the astral realm? So yes, it is, but truly I feel like, if you feel like you need protection in the astral realm, simply, going into the heart space and setting up your parameters with your soul, with you, and just basically saying, okay, we're going to stay within a certain bandwidth of frequency, and that is the heart-based, because there's a lot of stuff out there. And so if you go in and you're just like, okay, I'm going to go play in the darkest of the dark or whatever, or else you're just, you know, off to the winds and just going wherever you want to go. There's a lot of stuff out there. So, you know, you really don't need the MerKaBa for protection. The MerKaBa is connected to the physical meat suit. So it is something that we own as the physical being. You can have a MerKaBa that is connected to other planes, other, you know, realms of you. But when you astral travel, you know, if you're taking an aspect of your body, you can intend you take your MerKaBa, but really, if you start within those parameters of the sacred space of the heart, and you just simply say, hey, I'm only connecting to those that are within this higher consciousness, heart-based frequency, then you're perfect. Rochelle, let's see. Oh, yes, for the toxicity of air and water, thinking of East Palestine and other affected areas, columns of light are a great thing to do. You know, because doing that work of going into the heart and working with the elementals and just holding that space and bringing in the elementals, that's a great thing to do. You can also use the light columns that we do and ask the elementals to come through the light columns. they're part of it anyway. But if you, you know, put your intent in there, you're going to bring them to the forefront, because, you know, bringing in earth and the earth elementals. So two, when you are anchoring a column of light, you're connecting into the heart of the earth and to the heart of creation, you. So, you know, really a column of light might be a more potent and powerful way to work with that style of toxicity in energetics. And again, you know, when we do any of that work, it's always from the heart space and not trying to have a specific outcome, you know, oh, poor whoever in Palestine I saw on TV, I really need to help and fix them. And, you know, again, it's just going to, we can't violate the free will of a person on their soul journey and their path, but we can hold the light. And that's really where this whole concept of is, instead of coming in and using our mind and pushing energy and trying to make things from our mind, we come in and we just hold a space for that person to choose the higher potential, if that is a part of their path. So, I mean, that's just one heck of a concept that, you know, the whole concept of having, of going out and doing the work is where we used to be. That's what we based all of our tools on prior to this, but we're really stepping into a whole different way of working with energy and for the higher potentials to come through. And so that is simply just being in the heart and just letting the light shine without trying to fix or heal, because your light is so flipping powerful. And it is simply just a reminder to all of those that there are higher potentials to choose from. Samson, could the MerKaBa activation help harmonize the common cold or any flavor of dis-ease? For my cells, it's very applicable to balance the consciousness of the self-created imbalance. Can the wisdom wand or wisdom field energy be the simplest way to bring ourselves back into tune? Okay, so to bring yourself, gosh. So the MerKaBa, doing the MerKaBa activation whenever you feel off-centered and out of balance is a fantastic thing to do, because it does instantly align chakras and energy bodies, and it just brings you in and you're connected and grounded. And that's really the biggest thing for the MerKaBa, is that it's grounding, connecting, and just aligning and balancing. So doing the MerKaBa activation when you're feeling out of sorts is fantastic. So let's see, to bring yourselves back into tune. So really, when you're working on the body, again, you can use some of the tools, but really sitting with your body, going into the heart, sitting with your body, going into every cell, bringing in your light, your soul, and then moving your light into every cell. And if you have something like a cold virus, remember it is consciousness. It is a field of consciousness. And so as you raise your frequency and vibration, it shifts the vibration of it too. And you can also just bring it into your awareness, that cold virus, and simply bring that light to it. Because, you know, maybe that virus is there to serve you. You know, viruses do shifting and changing within the physical. So basically, whenever we get a cold virus, we're like, well, yay, let's harmonize that to our body. And let's ask for all the highest and best to come through with it. And so, you know, that's what we do, because it is a field of consciousness. And so harmonizing your cells by being in the heart space in meditation, bringing in your light, using your light to harmonize the cells, and then also using your light, your soul, that master creator you, to step in and harmonize that virus. And so really doing that, you know, just that in the heart space, intention, bringing in the soul is really the most potent and powerful way to bring your physical back into alignment. Linda, my 9-year-old granddaughter would like to be more tuned into the fairy kingdom. What can you suggest? The fairy wand. Most definitely the fairy wand. The fairy wand is one that is tuned into the fae. And so, yeah, the fairy wand is what I would suggest getting. You know, the harmony generators are good because, again, the harmony generators are working with more of the plant divas, the elementals, even the fae. So it's great for the environment. But if you're just a person that's wanting to connect into that field, then yes, the fairy wand would be the way to go. Does the golden fire and light wand have the upgraded new energy no matter when the wand was created? Yes, and gosh, my apologies for the continued confusion with new energy and wisdom. We're working on rebuilding the website and resetting it and everything, and so I should just get in there and get that changed before we go any farther. So what happened was when we first were coming in with that wisdom energy, we were calling it new energy. And it was still expanding and shifting, and we weren't sure where it was going. And so we were calling things new energy. And then we were also seeing it as the wisdom. So new energy and wisdom is exactly the same energetics. And again, my apologies for the confusion, but new energy and wisdom are the same energetics there. So all the wisdom wands, no matter when they're made, if we update that energetics to the wisdom or the wisdom wand, then yes, the wisdom wand that you had, even the original one, is updated energetically. And so there have been a few different updates to those wisdom wands throughout the time. So you always have the most current updated tool of the wisdom wand. And so two, we've been kind of anticipating a newer energy coming in and clearing out a bunch of the old energy stuff. So we're kind of in a big flux right now. But I tell you, by the end of March, I really believe we're going to be able to anchor in this new energy into a ring. And so I'm hoping that by the end of March, we're going to have another actual new energy. But yeah, the wisdom and new energy are the same, and your wands are good. Vindy, what are your suggestions to clear bad luck energy that seems to never leave? Can't seem to get a break from it. So that's quite a concept too, because that whole bad luck energy is that basically you are creator, and it is consciousness that patterns energy. Everything in this world, physical life situations, everything is energy. And that energy is not patterned by some outside thing. That energy is all patterned by your consciousness. And so everything that is within your personal reality, everything that you see in the world, is a part of your creation, of your consciousness patterning energy. Now, we do have a thing, mass consciousness, where we all live within mass consciousness, and we all have this agreed upon framework to pattern our energies, but they have to fit within that framework, which is what we're doing in March, is we're getting rid of those patterns so we can learn to pattern in new ways. I forgot where I was at. Oh, yeah, the bad luck energy. So basically, I had this huge epiphany a couple years ago, and it was basically that it had to do with a reflection of where I was at. So I would attract in those things. A book would fall on my toe, and I would get more flustered, and I would get more, you know, just mad and stuff, and just be steaming. And then more things would go wrong. And so that was where I first realized that those things that happen to us are truly a reflection of not only our consciousness, but our emotions and just kind of the holistic of us. So some of these patterns. So this bad luck is simply a pattern. And, you know, that's really a deep, deep question. And this is something that we're actually doing in Soul Alchemy, is we're going through in this 5 to 6 week course. And that's what we're doing, is we're learning about creation, our creation, and how to clear that creation. But basically, the first thing with this, Vindi, is awareness. So you are aware of this. And it's simply going into the heart space and making a clear conscious choice to your soul, to you as creator, and say, I'm done with this. I'm complete. I release this. I release this pattern. I release this pattern. And then you have to simply allow it to release. Here you don't go like, well, you know, it's been kind of fun. You know, unconsciously, we can still hold on to things. So that's why you have to make a clear conscious choice with yourself, with your soul, to release those patterns. Beautiful. I feel that. Good job. Oh, I feel a few of you letting those go. Very nice work. Whew. Victoria, just a thought on the previous question. I have the original fire and light wand, and I notice now when I use it, it feels very similar to the wisdom wand. And that is beautiful, beautiful, Victoria. So, you know, that truly is the thing with all the tools that we create. They are quantum tools. So you can actually, you can bring in those energetics. I mean, I was looking for a pencil or a pen, you know, because back when we were teaching light anchoring with the golden fire and light wands, you know, I'd always teach people, hey, you can use a marker or a pencil. This is just simply it's a prop, because you are truly, you're the one that is bringing in that higher dimensional tool. And that's kind of the same with this, is that this is simply a physical anchor to where the true power and potency lies, is in the higher dimensional aspect of the tool. And this is the physical anchor. And so when we are utilizing this wand, it is us, our consciousness, that's doing the work through intention, visualization, imagination. When we anchor a column of light, it is actually us that's doing the work. We're calling in on the quantum aspect, the higher etheric template of this tool. So totally, you can anchor in your wisdom wand into this. You know, all you have to do is tune into what that wisdom wand energetics is. And then once you have a hold of it, you bring it in, and this becomes the anchor point for that wisdom wand. So that is absolutely beautiful, Victoria. And thank you for sharing that. Renard, I gifted my silver copper quantum heart coil to a beautiful soul who needed it. Recently bought a nether, and I'm so attracted to that coil particularly. Are those combos of metals working to attract me? How are they working to attract me so much? You know, that's a good question, Renard. I'm not, you know, that silver and copper one is one that, you know, we were just going to do a limited run of those, but yeah, people have really been loving those. Now, I just tried the other day a silver and copper one. It's just not quite the same, but I made two of these. I'm going to hang them on my pendant here, but you know, I don't know. I like the feel of it. It's just, I don't know why that copper and silver one you're so attracted to. But yeah, there is something with the different energetics there that makes a subtle difference in those. All right, going back over here to chat and seeing what's happened. Well, thank you guys for everything you put into chat here. All right. So, yeah, I don't have anything else unless there's some more questions here. Like I say, we'll be back with 50 questions Friday in 2 weeks. And if you're a part of Soul Alchemy, I'll see you tomorrow. And again, we'll put this up on YouTube for further viewing. And Amber does such a great job. Thank you, Amber, for all the work you do to listen to every one of these videos and go through and timestamp them for YouTube. We all really appreciate that. So Anyway. Oh, Rochelle, how can I enhance my perception of the energies of the tools? So the first time I ever felt energy was from a Hedica, and I was blown away because I could feel energies for the first time in a Hedica. Now, it's going to be kind of individual, on how you feel energies, because we all feel and perceive differently. Some of us feel them, see them, know them, hear them, smell them, taste them. You know, there's a lot of ways that you can clairvoyant, you know, a lot of clairs that you can clair into the perception of the tools. To me, and I saw your question earlier there, and what came up right away was using a wisdom wand. I tell you, the full-size wisdom wand is one that I so love that tool. And it is one to me that most people can feel tangibly. So what you do with the wisdom wand is you just run energy to the meridians on your palms. Usually your left is traditionally receiving. Don't lock yourself into that. So, you know, what I usually suggest is just taking that wand, and I would suggest the full size copper brass wisdom wand, and just run energy. And don't try too hard. Be soft. Be in the heart space. Allow. And your soul knows your intention. It knows that you're asking to be able to feel energy. And so be in the heart space. Try to run that energy into the hand. And just allow yourself to feel it. Don't try. You know, just be soft. And you know, and two, you don't have to really feel the energy physically, of course, for it to be functioning and working. You know, kind of like a story when I wanted to see, I wanted to have my third eye sight. Every night before I went to bed, I would go into the heart space. I would ask my soul for all the downloads, attunements, and activations possible, so that I could see. And it took a couple years, but I was able to see after that. And so really, I think a lot of that too is just, just asking you to allow yourself to feel those energies, asking your body, asking your soul, so... That's where I would begin with that, Rochelle, is just doing the asking of your body, your soul, and being in the heart space when you're trying to feel those energies. All right. Well, cool. I think that is all for today then. Thank you all for being here again. Oh, cool, Rochelle, you have the little wisdom wand. And yes, I know it is being there. Good. Yep. That's usually it. When we ask the questions, we already know the answers. All right. Well, thank you all for being here again. And we'll see you in 2 weeks. And it's not too late to join Soul Alchemy. So you're welcome to jump on board with us. All right. Take care, you guys. Good to see you.